Hello students, welcome to examination preparatory classes. We are dealing with the subject risk management insurance. In this video, we will understand and study unit 1 of risk management insurance. The topic would be introduction to risk management and risk identification. First, we'll understand the definition of risk. Possibility of adverse results flowing from any occurrence. Risk arises out of uncertainty. Now, what do you understand by risk? Risk is a condition where there is a possibility of an adverse deviation from desired outcome that is expected or hoped for. It is nothing but an uncertain event due to which there will be loss which will be incurred to an individual. Risk is an uncertainty of loss. Peril, the important concept called as peril, is a source of loss. For example, it can be, the loss can occur due to fire, wind, storm, etc. Then we should understand what is hazard. Hazard is a condition which increases the likelihood of loss. So, what we understood here, risk arises out of uncertainty. When risk is said to exist, there must always be at least two possible outcomes. If it is known for certain that a loss will occur, there is no risk and at least one of the possible outcome is undesirable. We will understand the various types of risk. The first type of classification would be based on the consequence of the risk event. Then the second would be based on the nature of the event. And the third is based on the nature of the environment. So first we'll discuss the classification based on the consequence of the risk event. So classification based on the consequence of a risk event. Broadly, we can have two types of risk under this particular classification, that is speculative risk as well as pure risk. So as the name only suggests, what we understand by speculative risk is, speculative risk are those which may give loss or profit. For example, when we are speaking about the equity market operation, if investor purchase 100 shares of common stock, he or she would profit if the price of the stock increases, but would lose if the price declines. So what do you mean by this? He is speculating with the price. So other examples would be like horse race, betting on a horse race on a particular horse, then investing in real estate and going into business for yourself. So that comes in this comes in the consequence of the risk event. Then we have pure risk. Pure risk, as the name will suggest, they are associated with uncertainties which may cause loss. In pure risk situation, either a loss occurs or no loss situation or no loss occurs. There is no possibility for gain. These uncertainties may be due to perils such as fire, flood, etc. or may even arise from human action such as theft or accident. Now we will study classification based on nature of the event. So under this particular classification, we will be studying two types. It is fundamental risk as well as particular risk. A fundamental risk is one that affects the entire economy or large number of person or group within the community. Example can be a cyclical unemployment, war, earthquakes, and more recently terrorist attack. So these risks are caused by conditions that are beyond the control of individuals. Fundamental risk can be addressed only through social insurance and government programs. Insurance is not a viable solution in case of fundamental risk. Particular risk. A particular risk involves losses that arise out of individual events and are felt only by particular individuals and not by the entire community or group. Individuals rather than society bear the responsibility for dealing with these losses. For example, burning of a house or an automobile accident. So, particular or specific risks can be addressed through the use of private insurance, loss prevention or some other risk management techniques. Next, we will be studying classification based on the nature of the environment. So, we have static risk as well as dynamic risk. Static risk implies events taking place within a stable environment. They have a regular pattern of occurrence over time and can be reasonably predicted. They are caused by natural events, for example, fire, earthquake, death, accident and sickness. Dynamic risk, on the other hand, are typically present in the social environment and are produced by changes in economy and society. For example, social and market related events like unemployment or sudden decrease of a war. Now, very important to know about the sources of risk, students. Divided into external sources of risk as well as the internal sources of risk. Now, in external sources of risk, there are few factors like economic factors, natural factors and political factors. Whereas in case of internal sources of risk, we'll come to know regarding the operational factors, human factors, technological factors or physical factors. Now we'll try to understand the methods of handling risk. In this, broadly we'll be studying about the risk avoidance, loss control, risk retention, non-insurance transfers and insurance. We'll understand each one in detail. Now, risk avoidance. It is the elimination of risk. Investor can avoid the risk of a loss in the stock market by not buying or shorting the stocks. The risk of a venereal disease can be avoided by not taking precautionary measures. So you can basically avoid the risk by not participating in that particular event. Then we can study loss control. It works by either loss prevention, which involves reducing the probability of risk, or loss reduction, which minimizes the loss. Loss prevention requires identifying the factors that increase the likelihood of a loss, then either eliminating the factor or minimizing its effect. For example, we can understand that speed and driving, drunk, greatly increase auto accidents. Not driving after drinking alcohol is a method of loss prevention that reduces the probability of an accident. Then we'll understand what is risk retention. It is also known as active retention, and risk assumption is handling the unavoidable or unavoided risk internally, either because insurance cannot be purchased for the risk because it costs too much or because it is much more cost effective. Usually retained risk occur with greater frequency but have a low severity. Risk retention is retaining risk because the risk is unknown or because the risk taker either does not know the risk or considers it a lesser risk than it actually is. Now we can take an example for this risk retention. Smoking cigarettes can be considered a form of passive risk retention, since many people smoke without knowing the many kinds of disease and of the risk that they do know. They do not think it will happen to them. They assume, basically. Then we have non-insurance transfers. Risk can also be managed by non-insurance transfers of risk. The three major forms of non-insurance risk transfer are as contract, hedging, and the third one is for business risk by incorporating. Then methods of handling risk, we will be studying insurance, very important thing. Again, we will be discussing the insurance in detail in unit 3 of risk management insurance subject. Insurance, it is another major method that most people, businesses and other organizations can use to transfer pure risk by paying a premium to an insurance company in exchange for a payment of a possible large loss. Management of risk. Risk management is the identification, assessment and prioritization of risk, followed by coordinated and economical application of resources to minimize, monitor and control the probability and or impact of unfortunate events. Risk management refers to the systematic application of principles, approach and processes to the task of identifying and assessing risk and then planning and implementing risk responses. This actually provides a disciplined environment for proactive decision making. Then students, this is very important to understand the risk management process. The first and the foremost step is identification loss exposure. Now risk management consists of all efforts to preserve the assets and earning power of a business. Since risk management has grown out of insurance management, the two terms are often used interchangeably. However, risk management has a much broader meaning covering both insurable and uninsurable risk and including non-insurance approaches. The process of risk management is very important for all of us to understand. The first step towards risk management process is called identifying the loss exposure. Then we'll be studying analyzing the loss exposure, select the appropriate risk management techniques, then implement and monitor the risk management program. Then we'll study selecting the appropriate risk management techniques. So once the risk has been identified and assessed, all the techniques to manage the risk fall into one or more of these four major categories. These are very important categories. The first would be avoidance of risk, then reduction of risk, then retention of risk, and finally we will be understanding the transfer of risk. Now what if we have studied all these concepts in the earlier slide. Majorly avoidance of risk is avoiding the risk. A risk management policy statement is documentation of the risk involved in performing a specific action. Risk analysis results and management plans should be updated periodically. There are two primary reasons for this. What are the two primary reasons for what it is? In order to do the proper risk analysis and management plan should be updated periodically. Why? To evaluate whether the previously selected security controls are still applicable and effective, and to evaluate the possible risk level changes in the buying environment. Now, why one should go for risk management? That is very important. Some of the advantages of risk management. So it will encourage the firm to think about its threats in the future, in clarifying the risk involved. It encourages the firm to be better prepared. It lets the organization prioritize its investment and reduces internal disputes about money and how money should be spent. It reduces manpower duplication and it even reduces duplication of systems. Now, the risk identification
comes to business risk exposure.
Risk exposure and internal risk, risk identified is the classification of loss exposures into the various types or categories.
The process of risk management one broadly comes across the following types of objects.
Both there are risk management as a agent of managing them. First and foremost, risk management is a problem
for individuals and organizations
like various collection exposure of physical assets or property losses. Individually, exposure of financial assets, exposure of human assets or personal losses, exposure to legal liabilities and losses from external economic forces. The individual risk exposure, the principles of corporate risk management are also applicable to individual or personal risk management program. Individual risk management refers to the identification of pure risk faced by an individual or family and to the selection of the most appropriate technique for treating such risk. Individual risk management considers other methods for handling risk in addition to the insurance. Now, exposure of physical assets or property losses. Property insurance policies typically promise to indemnify the insured for damage to covered property on one of the two bases. The first one is called ACV, that is actual cash value, and the second one is called a replacement cost. Now we will understand what is this ACV. Actual cash value, as the name only suggests, is the cost presently to replace or repair the damaged property less the value of the physical depreciation. The replacement cost, also called reinstatement value, is the cost at the time of loss to replace destroyed or severely damaged property with the same or like kind of new property, or the cost to repair damaged property in each instance without deduction for any depreciation in property value. So, types of exposure of physical assets or property losses. So, we have direct loss, indirect loss, net income loss, decrease in revenues and increase in expenses. Now, direct loss, it is experienced when the property is directly damaged, destroyed or disappears on coming in contact with the peril. For example, a building destroyed by fire or jewel stolen from a safe locker. Then indirect loss, it refers to this, to a situation where the value of the property is lessened as a result of direct damage to some other property. For example, meat and wine gets damaged when the environment is altered on account of changes in temperature or humidity. Net income loss, it refers to reduction in net income, that is, you can say a revenue less expenditure of the business when property is damaged or destroyed. The loss may occur during the period until such property is replaced or restored to its former condition. Decrease in revenues, that is the fourth point. Here we can even study loss of rent, interruption in operations and contingent business interruption. Then increase in expenditure, these may similarly be incurred when a firm has to spend extra money in the wake of damage to property. One such expense is rental charges incurred when the owner, occupant or a tenant has to occupy alternative premises. This is because suspending all operations might lead to loss of credibility, customer goodwill and damage the business permanently. Then we have exposure of financial assets. Now, financial asset exposure is normally any risk associated with any form of financing. Risk is probability of unfavorable condition. In financial sector, it is the probability of actual return being less than the expected return. So, here types of financial asset exposure. So, we will be studying the credit exposure, the currency exposure as well as the country exposure. So, credit exposure is the possibility that the customers who have been granted credit will either fail. So, they might fail to pay, right? When the payment is due, or will delay payment and take longer credit than agreed. So, failure to pay is a bad debt risk that has a direct impact on the profits. Then currency exposure involves losses from adverse movements in foreign exchange rates. Both it can be short term and long term. It affects any company that sells abroad or buys from abroad in foreign currency, or that has foreign subsidiaries. Country exposure arises from an adverse change in the financial condition of a country in which a business operates. So again, there are three aspects of country risk, that is, the political exposure is there, regulatory exposure is there, and economic exposure is there. Exposure of legal liability or liability losses. So liability for causing harm to others is the second major object of risk. The term liability is a synonym with responsibility and carries a penalty for not meeting it. Now, types of legal liability or liability losses exposure. It can be arise from it can arise from ownership, arise from manufacture, arise you know from fiduciary relations and employer's liability. Now, how it can arise from ownership? Liability may arise out of ownership, use or possession of premises. This implies a reasonable responsibility to keep the premises safe and to avoid any cause for public or private trouble. Now, arise from manufacture, arises from manufacture. Liability arises from the manufacture, distribution and sale of products and services by the firm. Responsibility may arise from breach of warranty or from a defective product or even process. For example, you can say wrong selling of a life insurance plan may invite penal provision. Then arise from fiduciary relation. Liability can also arise from fiduciary relation. For example, we can study a firm director or firm's director hold a position of trust and are enjoyed with the duty of care and loyalty to shareholders and other stakeholders. Failure to discharge this duty can be cause for liability. Then employer's liability. Employer's liability for job-related injuries and disease form a fourth source. They are typically met by workman's compensation insurance. So, risk management techniques in work-related injuries. So, risk avoidance basically loss prevention and loss reduction. So, risk avoidance means a certain loss exposure is never acquired or an existing loss exposure is abundant. For example, what we can say is a firm may decide not to use a certain machine or piece of equipment in the production process because of potential injury to employees. Loss prevention refers to measures that reduce the frequency of a particular loss. For example, we can say highway accidents are a major cause of death for employees in the transportation and warehousing industries. Measures that reduce the truck accidents include driver examination, a proper examination of the driver, zero tolerance for alcohol or drug abuse, you know, and strict enforcement of safety rules. So we can avoid the loss. Then loss reduction refers to measures that reduce the severity of a loss after it occurs. For example, in a professional sports, the incident rate of a disabling injury is relatively high. So, for example, a daily newspaper may have a disaster plan for printing the paper at an alternate location if the main plant is damaged by a fire, tornado, flood or any other cause. As a result, revenues continue and the total loss is also reduced. Such measures reduce the severity of losses after they occur. So, what we are studying, students? Risk management techniques in work-related injuries. Students, thank you so much for watching this video. For any kind of ambiguity, kindly contact me. So, I'll try to solve all your queries. But one humble request to all of you is, you need to study, so that the concepts will be clear. So, thank you so much once again for watching this video.